How to Talk to Anyone, a practical guide to avoid anxiety, shyness, and awkwardness. Make real friends and generate deep conversations the right and simple way. Written by Richard Hawkins. Narrated by Orlena Cain. Introduction. Congratulations on downloading this book, and thank you for doing so. The following chapters will discuss all the pertinent information that you need to advance your communication skills to a more master level. You will start by exploring verbal communication, as well as the accompanying body language and other nonverbal elements. This is important because you need to master this form of communication before the others. The next step will be looking at both digital and manual forms of written communication. You will get a chance to take your ability to do everything from writing emails to handwriting a memo to the next level. Your visual and video communication abilities will be discussed next. Since technology is so important in today's world, these are two forms of communication that need to be mastered to become an advanced communicator. You will be exposed to both group and one-on-one communication. While there are many similarities between the two concerning techniques, the differences are what you need to focus on to better advance your skills. This book will go beyond just the communication type basics. You will explore formal versus informal communication. You will learn when each is appropriate and the different subtypes that exist. More advanced communication types and techniques are introduced. You will learn about expressive versus receptive communication, as well as how to effectively communicate with those with specific challenges, such as having autism or being visually or hearing impaired. The final chapter explores conflict communication. There are very specific elements to consider when you need to communicate in an atmosphere where there might be hostility present. There are plenty of books on this subject on the market. Thanks again for choosing this one. Every effort was made to ensure it is full of as much useful information as possible. Please enjoy. Chapter 1. Combining Verbal and Nonverbal Communication. Verbal communication is almost primal. It is at the very foundation of your daily life, and you do it without even thinking about it. You say hello to your friends and quickly provide an answer to a coworker's questions. This form of communication tells others a lot about you, especially concerning your technique. It typically includes both your words and the nonverbal cues that you give. The nonverbal element of verbal communication is largely unconscious. For example, someone asks if you are okay. You are having a rough time, but you tell them that you are fine. Your body language can tell the other person that you are not being truthful and that something is wrong. Perhaps you have a negative facial expression, or you do not look them in the eye when answering. This is why both verbal and nonverbal communication goes hand in hand. Consider advertising to see the impact that verbal and nonverbal communication have when they are working together. You are at a mall and there is a booth set up to demonstrate the latest blender. The salesperson demonstrating the product is passionate, upbeat, and really draws you in. Now, his words are what give you the merits of the blender, but his body language is what keeps you interested in what he is saying. The example describes a situation that you are exposed to on a daily basis. Consumers are constantly making purchasing decisions based more on the presenter than the product or service itself. How many things have you purchased in the last 5 years that just did not live up to the hype? Most people have at least one. Now, what made you think it was a good purchase decision initially? It ultimately comes down to the verbal and nonverbal communication utilized by the person telling you about the product. Body language in verbal communication. Like you have learned, body language is almost like a natural and unconscious lie detector. You can tell a friend that you are fine when they ask, but if your body language says otherwise, they know that you are not being truthful with them. The next time you are considering a product or service based on advertising, consider the nonverbal cues. In this industry, the following are used to persuade consumers to make a purchase. Showing people where to look. using eyes to make a stronger point, pointing to the most attractive element, smiling to convey a sense of the product or service causing happiness, using the right colors to persuade, using dollar amounts to convey a feeling of greater value. Now that you know what these persuasive verbal cues are, it is time to start using them in all your verbal communications. This might seem manipulative, but it is not. Instead, use your body language to strengthen the point that you are trying to make. This is helpful in all areas, but especially when you are at work. For example, you are up for a promotion and three other coworkers are being considered. What you say during your interview must match your body language to convince the interviewer that you are truly the best candidate for the promotion. You want to combine your verbal and nonverbal communication to create an atmosphere that is warm and humble, but also exciting. In this type of situation, you are essentially selling yourself, so using tried and true advertising techniques will be your most effective communication tool. Verbal communication skills to master. Certain communication skills may appear basic on the surface, but mastering them will make you the most advanced communicator possible. The following are the skills you want to focus on. Make sure that you are friendly and approachable. This automatically makes people more open to hearing what you have to say. It also gives you a chance to provide some feel-good vibes to those you are speaking with. Before you speak, take a few seconds to consider what you will say. You have certainly heard sayings that state that silence can be your best answer. This is true. There are times when not saying anything is the best way to communicate. If a verbal response is warranted, you want to ensure that it is received in the way that you intend it to be. A quick second to think will help you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.